This is 7 Days to Die, Episode 3. I am the Pack Rat. Call me Glendin. And I am on. I have a broken leg. I am infected. I am hunted. And I am. Yeah. Aloe vera. I can't pick it up. Great. I want what he's dropping. I am not going to fight this guy. I found out, I looked up the crossbow, and I found out what's what with it, and guess what? We have to find a recipe for it. You're only going to drop one crate, huh? Well, I'm going after that crate, hopefully. I cannot run, I got a sprained leg. I'm going to try to run anyway. I have some denim pants. I have a little. How would I put them on? Denim pants to cover up my fuggliness. Oh, that's cool. I need to get up there and find out where that's dropping as it drops. So if it's too far away, I'm never going to get it. Oh, shut up. Get off me. My hit points are really low. I doubt I could take a fight with anyone. And now I'm tired. Seems to me when you fight and die, you get less and less hit points every time you die. So my hit points are down to like nothing, and it takes a long time to recuperate. Oh, come on, where's the crate? That crate could be anywhere in this kind of terrain. That could be a good place to sit for a while, but still. Come on, where'd the crate go? I really need a crossbow, honestly. So, they have made dying a something you really don't want to do, no matter what. Because you come back with less and less hit points until you can't survive them actually sneezing on you. If walkers actually sneeze without losing their nose. Alright, I'm going to go up top of this hill, look around for the crate. If I can't find it, I'm heading on. Because I am infected. And the only way to get rid of that infection is with antibiotics or dying. Which means I lose even more hit points. Permanently. Or, yeah, until I can't really use that. I could, but I mean this. Not now at this point. I will keep that, though, because I probably will need that. No, I don't see no crate. I thought it'd be up here, and I thought I could see it, but apparently it's way over there. That could be misleading on I web it. Yeah, apparently they've changed a lot, and in order to make just about anything other than really, really crude, you need to have, and really crude is that bow, you need to have a schematic for it. I seem to have a hammer schematic, so I can now build things. I think what I need now is to build a hatchet and start harvesting wood. Oh, we have a building. Once I get a hatchet, I'm going to put these couches down and bust them up into cloth fragments to make more bandages out of it. It's a good thing to keep a heap of bandages on you. Never know when you're going to need them. And I'm still looking for an antibiotic. What? Glue? That's a shotgun, but without the rest of the parts for it, it really isn't useful. And I'm going to be more crossbow than weapons and guns. Yeah, than other weapons. Crossbow, I used to just, you know, if you're a fan of The Walking Dead, I used to be more Daryl in this game than anything else. I would beat the hell out the walkers and shoot them in the head with the crossbow. And I want to sneak and be undetected, but let's check this place out. But I got a sprained whatever, and I should actually put something on that. Which means when I go and hunker down like this, it means I'm moving at a snail's pace. Can I actually get in here? Ooh, there's a bag. Bags can have ammo, weapons, all kinds of stuff in it. And oh yeah, there is armor in this game. Oh, that's just a stone. Really? It sounds like there's somebody in there. Something in there. Now, in a normal multiplayer game, and the reason why I didn't do this is I do have a friend who has a server, but, you know, you can build a bunch of stuff and go from one episode to another and log in and have somebody destroy all the stuff for you, so. You look like you're, crap. Well, I want those, but I don't want you. No hit points. I have no hit points, and I can't run from them. Sometimes these have actually stuff on them that's useful. Nope. He's a nude walker. Aw, crap. See? See how that works? You will die many, many times in this game in the beginning. Unless, of course, you have a team of people with you. Which is... Okay, my cap increased? Was that I have no idea. I'm looking fugly. I don't know what glue is for. Alright, I'm going to keep picking up rocks, and we're going to find that my backpack is in that direction. And I need to pick up rocks for bows and arrows and crossbows, and I'll get that eventually. They're difficult to pick up sometimes. I need a hatchet and I need wood. So, let's work on a hatchet before nightfall. Let's see. Tools. Stone axe. Let's get one of those. That might be helpful. I went right in almost the right place. About number two. But we put that here. It's a barbed wire club. I can't get up a hill. Which means that could probably be a good place to hide from zombies. Oh, and there's a pig. If I only had a crossbow or a hunting rifle, I'd have some real food. Let's avoid that crawler. Can't really call it a walker, can we? We're going in a general direction. There's another one there. Well, I have, by dying, I cured my infection, and I cured my sprained leg, and I cured my low hit points, and if only I could get that pig. Here, Peggy. Here, Peggy. I doubt I could get close enough to that pig. Even sneaking. I am going in the right direction, though. Need to find bird nests and stuff too. If I don't find bird's nests, I won't be making any arrows. Or anything remotely like that. What I want to do is chop a couple of trees down. I really need the wood. It used to be that you could make wooden frames. And a wooden frame would block a lot of stuff. You could put them in place of doors and things like that after you cut through a door. Wow, this is going to take a while. As it should, but I didn't remember it being like this. It is an axe. Oh yes, that is a nice falling tree. It used to be they just dropped into the ground, but that was a very nice way for it to fall. It's not spraying nothing. I want to check the other side to make sure I didn't lose. That was a much better way of doing trees. Much better. I have a little bit of wood. We're still heading back to my backpack, and now that I have an axe, and I might actually be able to get past those walkers that were there and check the inside. I know, I'm the pack rat. I've got too much stuff. Now over there is what I really should be checking out. Well, it's daylight. Run through there real quick, see what I can grab. And get the hell out. That might actually be my... Well, see, the problem with points of interest that are already on the map, and that's what they call them, is they're also spawn points for critters. Zombies, walkers. Building your own somewhere on the map doesn't come with spawn points. Where is the stairs? I would never get through this stuff. Although, checking the inside of that is very, I'm very interested in checking the inside of that. Can I get through the door? Can I get around? Ah, shit. Can I run around the side and get in the door? And then check everything real quick and then run out the other side? How about we just go up the stairs real quick? Door? Aw, crap. Of course it's going to be locked. There's probably somebody in there, too. There is somebody in there beating everything up. You know. Come here, you. Infected again. Great. Check the place real quick. Food. Raw pork. I don't dare have that on me. If I were able to cook it real quick, that's a different story, but... making so much noise. This is actually useful here for boiling water and stuff. I don't see a I want to go downstairs without a torch. I think something's down there. There could be... I don't care about that right now. Aww. I'm looking for a safe. Something that might have a... All I'm gonna find is junk. Food. I need to put that up here. Place of stuff that's crap. Of course it's all locked. I'm never gonna get out of here without getting my ass whooped. And there's not much left on this axe either. I'll rest a minute and check this. Ooh! We have stuff. Least useful right now is that. So you can find blueprints anywhere now, hmm? Oh, shit. This is where I die. I'm not going to get a chance to look in there. I broke the axe, so I can't actually get in there, so. Well, I do have a schematic for leather boots, so it wasn't all bad. And I'm infected again, so. Yeah, I'll go figure. I usually not like to get that close to a walker, strictly because of infection, but there's nothing you can do about it. They used to be berry bushes, but I guess they're not anymore. They're making it really hard to get through this. Let's get back to that general direction. I don't think I really lost too much last time that was worth it. Crap. Didn't really keep much on my bar. Now, a couple of these are worth something. I've already used that schematic once, so there really is nothing else for me to do with that. And I'll use this schematic right now. I learned that somehow. There we go. So I'll just keep that on my hot bar for now. So if I lose it, I don't care. I do want to keep these, and I do want to keep that. Keep these, and definitely that for cooking. I don't really care about pine seeds. I can throw them away. Gunpowder, I don't care about. Blocks, I thought I could block something up with those, but now that I have some wood, I'm going to make some frames. Scrap lead and scrap stuff, you know. Until I actually start having a way to manufacture weaponry, that's not going to do me much good. Let's head back toward that building. I might have to just hunker down in the, come on, give me a... I might have to just hunker down in the middle of nowhere. I'll take these. Nails are only good for building, which I'm not actually doing much of right now. Hmm. wonder what that eggcorn means. Modifiers. One health every 60 seconds. Not enough food to... You have enough food to slowly heal. That's what that means. Okay. Yeah, in the early parts of these games, you want to be a little nomadic. You want to be able to range around and find stuff and... Oh, it looks familiar, like I've been through that before. This is the direction I was when I died last. If I don't find an antibiotic, I will be dying again. But maybe I can find a place to hold up and have some storage. And there's a bear. No, not a bear. I still have to look for a schematic for a crossbow. If I had a crossbow, I could easily take zombies out without getting infected. I would not have a problem. That's the way I used to play the game. But, things have gotten harder in here. Really difficult. And like I was saying in the first episode, and then got sidetracked. Shit me. Surrounded by walkers, now get ate by a bear, right? I think that's the only way I can get up there. Well, we might be seeing a bear up close. Shit. Not me. Go eat a walker. Get out of here. I bet you they move a whole lot faster than a walker does. Anyway, what I was saying about survival, in this kind of game, the first aspect of survival doesn't come into play. And the first aspect of survival is deciding to survive. I've said this in my other series, in case you haven't seen it or heard of it before, I'll let you know. It's when you're in a survival situation, there's many different ways of thinking about your survival. Some people are like, no, that's not happening, and that's, you know, this can't happen, and I'm going to ignore it, and... Oh, shit. Another way to look at your survival, and it's if it's a plane crash situation or something else like that, I want to get that real quick before she gets me. Feathers, feathers, feathers. Yes, feathers. Take feathers. Run. Some people will hunker down and wait for rescue, like if you're a shipwreck on a deserted island or something like that. And other people will go ahead and try to find ways to survive. If you wait and nobody comes, you're dead. By the time you actually get to the point where you're, okay, deciding that now I'm going to survive and I'm going to do it all myself because nobody's coming to help me, you're already too weak and you're too, you know... You don't have enough resources left, physically, mentally, to survive. So the best thing is, plan on never having someone rescue you and survive on your own. You and nature and you or whoever you're with, survive on your own. And if a rescue does come, great. It's perfect that a rescue has come. I have to go that way, and I'm hearing a bear over there. You know, don't wait for survival, no matter what. Don't wait for somebody to rescue you in order for you to survive. I said it wrong. Take survival into your own hands, because you're the one that's going to die, not the people rescuing you. If nobody ever comes, then all you are a corpse. That's one of the first... things about survival that everybody will mess up on. Let's say that you have a walker infestation. You have a zombie apocalypse or something going on. The first thing is disbelief. You won't believe it's happening. You won't believe, you know, not that it ever could, really. It's fantasy. But in a situation where something's going bad, disbelieving it and not starting up as, okay, now I'm going to survive, is the worst thing you can do. Stay within laws, stay within, you know, what you have to do, proper everyday life, but keep your mindset that this may be a survival situation and I need to keep my ears open and my eyes looking around, and you need to really check what you're doing. And the first thing that'll happen is you have to decide to survive. Are you going to survive, or are you just going to say, well, no, I don't want to live this way. If I can't have my computer and my Xbox and my TV set and all this other crap, and I can't survive without it. And you have to go past that decision and make a decision on survival first. And once you've decided to survive, then you can put those thoughts away and get to the point of actually surviving. Oh, piggy. And then you need shelter, food, water. Not necessarily in that order, because if something's stalking like walkers, you need shelter first, then water, then food. But, you know, you can survive without water for days. You can dehydrate in one day if it's high temperature. I'll go away. You can survive. You know, there's one way in up there. I had some frames built. Let's see about, very quickly, building some lumber. Maybe some frames to try to get up in there, or beat through a wall. I don't know. How should we get in there? You. You're doing a good job on that. I don't have actually backpack here, I think. Or is it here? It's here. I just have crap in it, but I would have to beat through that door to get in, because there is no other door. I don't think whatever I'd find in there is worth beating through that door. Let's go out into the desert where it's easier to see at a distance, and the critters can't sneak up on you so easy. And yeah. And I can go sit on a mesa and look out in the distance to see who's coming after me. Let's go down this slow and not kill myself. Let's get a sleeping bag made so that I can respawn right where I die, because I'm going to die again. I'm infected. It'll be a few days, but let's go out here across the road or something. But anyway, like I'm saying, there's a yucca plant. There's two more of them over there. I really need a place to hunker down for the night. Duct tape. I'm not sure what that gets used for now. And now it's getting dark. Now a torch would be handy. So let's put one in hand. Yeah. Bird nest. Always bird nest. Let's have it always, even if it's only to get eggs from. If you keep on the move, they won't get you that easy. It's when you stop is when you're having problems. I know that these are very useful and those aren't. You have to melt them down, or used to be melting them down. That's not wood anymore, is it? I'd have to chop that out, wouldn't I? Used to be you could pick those up. Used to could. Yo. I will take that for later. So let's Yeah, okay. I will find plenty of lead when I mine later. That I can build, make drink out of. I'm not sure where I'm going or what I'm doing. I don't want to walk off something. But yeah, what I was saying before is you have to first get past the decision to survive, that you want to keep living. And then you have to make the decision of, yeah, I'll do what I need to do to survive, even if it's eating nasty things, even if it's, you know, killing an animal to make... Crap. I'm going to die again. Light on fire or something, you witch. See, I knew that was going to happen. Anyway, what I was going to suggest doing was I start each episode in the morning and then play through the day and end the episode at night when I'm hunkered down and hiding. So, yeah, why don't we do that from now on? I'll, when I come back in here, go get my stuff and find a place to sit and or just wait for morning and do it that way. Because no matter what I'm doing, where I am, it's going to be nighttime, and you're not going to see anything. I'm going to go get that waypoint I had and get rid of it. Anyway, this is the end of the episode, and I'm still not too far away. I haven't lost my, you know, I don't want to set waypoint. I want to get rid of waypoint. How do I get rid of the waypoint? Oh. There we are. Yeah, I will find my stuff again, or I really didn't have much stuff that I lost. Does it really matter? I'm going to hunker down and hide till morning, even if I die again. I'll start the next episode in the morning when the sun rises, and the zombies are slower and the bears won't eat me. And I will see you next episode. Please leave a like if you like what I'm doing. This playthrough is basically you're coming along on a ride with me as I play the game. And please subscribe to the channel. It's free. Just press the button. It helps me by raising my subscription and, you know, it helps me out a lot. And there's a bear. Okay, I'll catch you next episode. Thank you for watching.